Data changed my life, and I'm here today to tell you how. At 21, I built my first startup. Back then, I was just a student, studying computer science and learning about new technologies. Meanwhile, I was very, very motivated to do something better in my life. So I had this fire in the belly. I was looking for new technologies and what was trending back then. And I saw that fidget spinners were trending back then, and I started to follow the founders or the patent owners of fidget spinners about 8-9 years ago. And they were like teenagers, 17, 20-year-old boys, and they became millionaires. And imagine someone who is 20, 21, coming from an average family, studying and doing two part-time jobs to fund the education. So what I did is I started to follow them, and I saw their fancy lifestyle, expensive dinners, and what they could add, what kind of value they could add to their families. And this started my journey. I established my first startup, which was a directory app, and we started to do sales. And it was some months were good, some months were low. But what we saw is that we actually had the user base that is growing. We had a user base that was growing, but we couldn't make any high revenue. And obviously, selling $10 subscriptions were not going to fund my private jets and the expensive dinners that I was looking forward to. And what we did is we started to expand our company within Europe, and we just saw the return of the investment of our marketing efforts. The momentum was built. And fast forward a year, I sold the company to its largest e-commerce company in the industry. And here I had it, six figures. And after that, I was curious why they acquired the company. I was not asking much questions, as you could imagine. I was an inexperienced entrepreneur. And I realized that there must be a good value in it, because we were not making high revenues, and it's obviously not about the product, because the product is not the best directory app in the market. So I sat down with them, and it kicked me. They acquired the company for six figures, which was almost 1/5 or 1/6 of their digital marketing budget for the year. And I just saw that after they told me that they're gonna amplify data analytics with the data that we have. So basically what they do is they're acquiring our company, and they get potential 500,000 clients. And what they do with that is they see the timing, which day are they active, which day are they looking for restaurants, which day are they looking for cigar bars. And according to that, they optimize their digital sales strategy. Instead of spending $10,000 in 7 days, they're spending $10,000 on Monday evening, and they have the same return of investment on that. And that led me to go more into data. So I went to Silicon Valley. I went to Draper's University, which is great. And I learned more about angel investments and entrepreneurship. And there I saw it. The ecosystem of startups is based on data and metrics. All the venture capitals, all the angels, all our startups, it's basically a data. And according to that data, funds start to invest. And I don't know if there are some founders today with us. I do believe there are some entrepreneurs. And I can tell you that all the VCs got you tracked, man. Like all the VCs, if you have a company based in Delaware, if you have a company based in Wyoming, if you have any company that is in a global startup hub, they are tracking you. They are tracking your LinkedIn. They are tracking your company's website and the growth. And according to that growth metrics, you will be one of the candidates that can receive investments from a range from $100,000 up to $10 million, $25 million in pre-seed stage. 66% of the startups VCs, they use AI-enhanced tools to gather data and to simplify the bulk data. And through that, they're creating their patterns to find you or you. And I think that's one of the things that shocked me. 8 years forward, I'm standing here in Miami, not to tell you that AI is going to replace us or robotics is going to be the next new world order. I'm today here to tell that the fundamental of all this is data. If you don't have data, you don't have AI. If you don't have data, you don't have robotics, which works with AI as well. So you have to build something that acquires data and that simplifies the data and eventually gives an output that you can gain insights or create patterns to make better investments or bring out new products to the market. 8 years wiser, I found Lemon Rocks about 6 to 8 months ago, which is a business intelligence platform to track startups. Or if you're a VC, you can track startups. If you're a startup, you get visibility to those VCs. And we're a platform that not only tracks Web2 startups, but what we do else is we also track on-chain and digital assets. For example, if there is the new Shiba or there is the new meme token that is rising, you can also find this. But you can also check the Nasdaq price or the Tesla's price on the stock, which is very unique and it doesn't exist. So I'm very glad on that. We successfully raised $750,000 at 8 million valuation just recently. And we are looking forward to expand our team within US as well. We have ex-Crunchbase, ex-Dropbox people in our team. So there are three takeaways that I would love to give you from my experience today. The first one is leverage data. If you have a company, you have to get the data, and through that data, you have to create a pattern. There are a lot of AI tools, as you've seen in other speeches and other presentations, to ask how to do that, but I'm sure you'll figure it out. And second one is use the growth metrics. All data that you have, it's the KPIs, it's the product metrics. These are all being used as a presentation. Guys, it's not about the pitch deck anymore. It's not about the idea anymore. It's about the metrics and the data that you have or you can acquire. That is the potential that venture capitalists see as an investment opportunity. And the third one is be visible. Use social media accordingly. Register yourself, get whitelisted on Lemon Rocks, or register yourself on other business intelligence platforms. And use LinkedIn and other platforms accordingly. So, data changed my life, and I think it can change yours too. And thank you for listening.